This conference will now be recorded.
See, everyone, please join the session immediately. You'll wait for 2 minutes and we will start. Okay. See, I think in the last class we have discussed about what we have discussed in the last class. Okay. See, we have discussed about the fundamental characteristics and timeliness, jitter, delivery, and as well as delivery, accuracy, timeliness, and jitter. That means the basic fundamental characteristics, how your data communications is going to depend on. Those are the 4 points. Okay, and next one is about the components. How many components are there in the data communications? That is the only 5 points are there. That is the message, sender, receiver, and as well as transmission medium. Okay, transmission medium. And next one is the data representation. We have seen how the data can be represented. What are the different ways of representing your data? It can be in the form of text, or it can be in the form of numbers, or it can be in the form of images, or it can be in the form of audio files or video files. Anything we can consider it as data files. Okay. And next one is the data flow. Also, we have seen that is the mode of communication. It will comes under the modes of communication. How your data can be communicated, and what are the 3 different ways of communication. So that is, one is simplex form of communication, and the other one is half duplex, and the third one is the full duplex mode of communication, right? So already we have seen in the simplex mode it is the unidirectional, and in the half duplex mode it is bidirectional, but we can't send the data simultaneously at the same time. But in the full duplex mode, it is it's like both the stations, they can send and receive the data at the simultaneously at the same time, right? And the next concept is the network. Network also we have seen. What is that network? Networks is nothing but the devices which are communicated or connected using the links. It can be any of the links. It can be the twisted pairs, or it can be optical fibers, or it can be microwaves or radio waves, anything. Okay. That is called as networks. And how these networks is going to depend on. So networks completely, it is going to depend on the distributed processing networks. Okay, that means our tasks we are going to divide in multiple computers. Our tasks we are going to divide it in the multiple computers. So that is called as a distributed networks. And from these multiple computers, we will try to extract our data. Okay. And next one is the network criteria. So what is that network criteria here? Network criteria means it must be able to meet the number of things. What is that number of things? Means performance, reliability, and as well as security. So in the performance, how can we measure the performance of a network? How can we say whether your network performance is good or bad? So that is mainly, it is based upon two things. One is the transit time, and the other one is the response time. So what is the transit time? It is nothing but the amount of time it is taken to travel your message from one device to the other device. It is called as the transit time. And the next one is the response time. So what is that response time here? Response time, it is nothing but the lapse time between an inquiry and as well as response is nothing but the response time. Okay. So your performance, it is going to depend basically on the number of factors, that is the number of users, and as well as the type of transmission medium that which we are going to use it. So two things your network is going to depend on, and one more thing is the throughput and as well as reliability. So what is that throughput here? What is that throughput? Already we have discussed that the number of the maximum number of users, or the maximum the number of users that which we are going to use our network, is nothing but the throughput here. Okay, so here how we will consider means the number of data packets that which we can send per unit time is nothing but the throughput here. If you are trying to send more amount of data, what happens? All obviously your delay, it will also be increased. See here, that is the reason. If you try to send a more and more amount of data into the network, obviously what will happen? you can increase the throughput, but in the same way, simultaneously, your delay and as well as your traffic will also be increased in this, this one, in the network. Okay, so that is nothing but how we can calculate the performance of data communications and as well as networks. Okay, and one more thing is the reliability. Okay, what is this reliability here? So how can we measure our reliability? How can we measure our reliability means it can be measured in terms of the number of failures that are there, the number of failures that are there, the frequency of the failure. That means suppose if any failures are there, means how much time it is going to be taken to recover from that failure is nothing but the reliability. Okay, how much fastly we are trying to recover from that particular failure is nothing but reliability. And next one is the security. So remember, when you are trying to send any data in online, we need to keep an eye on the security also. Why? Because many number of hackers and cyber criminals are there, those who are ready to attack our data immediately. So that is the reason we should protect our data from unauthorized users access. Okay, unlegitimate users access. So that is the reason we should consider definitely security issues also. Okay, so there may be a chance of data breaches will be there, data losses will be there, and damage of data will be there, or stealing of some personal information will be there. So that is the reason we should compulsory focus on the security issues also. Okay, and next, if we come to the physical structures, there are two types of connections are there. So what are the two types of connections we are having? The one is point to point connection and the other one is the multi-point connection. Right, so what is that point to point connection? It is nothing but a dedicated link is there which is established between the two devices. Okay, if only one communication channel is used between the two devices, means that is called as a point to point connections. Okay, that means that particular entire channel capacity I am going to reserve only for the two devices. Okay, only two devices can use that complete capacity of that channel. So that is called as point to point links. So here for that point to point links, they have given the example of your television remote. How your television remote is trying to use with the help of remote controls and all. Okay. And next one is the multi point or multi drop connections. So what is that multi point or multi drop connections here? So here more than two specific devices are there where we can share our single links. Okay, that means one capacity of one channel, it can be shared to the multiple number of devices using a one single link. That is called as multi-point or multi-drop connections. Okay, and next one is the physical topology. So this is the physical topology. That means physically how can we represent our point to point connection or as well as multi-point connections, our point-to-point connections and as well as multi-point connections. Okay, so already we have seen the categories of networks also, right? We have seen the mesh topology, star topology, bus topology, and as well as ring topology also. That means it will shows how your devices, that means how your computers are connected physically with the help of some cables. That means it can be twisted pairs or coaxial cables. Anything we can use it for the interconnection of devices, right? So star topology we have seen, bus topology we have seen, and as well as ring topology also. So if anybody need means, again I can explain. So if there is no need means, we can proceed to the next topic. Okay, is it clear? These are the topics which we have discussed in the last class. Next one is the network models. Okay, we will see what are those networks models and all. And next topic is categories of networks.
How many categories of networks are there?
How many categories of networks are there means I think everybody knows about these things, but still I will explain you once again. So what is this categories of networks means? Majorly three categories of networks are there, that is the local area network, local area network, and as well as Local area network, how many types are there? Wide area network and as well as metropolitan area networks are there. So majorly three categories of networks are there. So we will discuss about the first one, that is the local area network. So how many knows about that local area network? Any knowledge about the LAN? Any knowledge about the LAN, where we can use this particular LANs? So based upon the geographical location and the geographical distance, they have been categorized into these three categories. Okay, that means how much distance our network is able to survive. Based on only that concept, they have categorized into the three types. So first one is the local area networks. So if any connection of the devices can be done in any organization or in any university or in any hospital, okay, or in any schools, such type of networks are called as local area networks. Okay, so suppose if our college is there, in our college we are having LAN connections are there. So how our connections can be established in our networks here? See, I think this is the same way where we are trying to interconnect our systems, right? So in the lab, if you observe, so this many number of systems which are connected in some linear topology here, so all these particular connections again we are trying to interconnect to some one big hub will be there. Okay, to this particular hub will be there, and the to this particular hub we will try to interconnect. So that's how your local area networks will be working. Okay, I don't know how many of you observe in between the lab you will be having one switch will be there, very big switch will be there. In that one again racks of switches will be there, small switches will be there, where we can interconnect. 24 port switches will be there, 48, like that 32 port switches will be there. So based upon the interconnectivity, based upon the switches capacity, that many systems we can interconnect individually. Okay, and we can access the internet also. So that means it will be intended only to some few distance or to some few kilometers. Okay, the distance, it is the major constraint in this particular LANs. Okay, we can share our resources, we can share our data, each and every computer, it can talk with the other computer also. Okay, that's how our LAN is going to work here. So distance is the major constraint. That means what is the distance they have given it here? They have given the data speeds. So here the speed generally they gave it as 100 or 1000 Mbps. For a LANs, that means this much Mbps of data we can transmit using the LANs. Okay, what is the Mbps full form? And next one is a wide area network. So what is this wide area network again here? Okay, before going into this wide area network, we will go for metropolitan area networks. So still now we have seen about how our interconnections can be done to an individual houses. In our individual houses also LAN connections will be there. Is it true or not? So how that LAN connections can be done using any twisted pairs or coaxial cables, and from there it will be connected directly to the internet service providers. Okay, so that's how our LAN is going to work in the individual houses. And next one is in the metropolitan area networks. Metropolitan, the name itself indicates that we are trying to interconnect the major metropolitan cities in our country. That is called as metropolitan area networks. Okay, first they started with only normal computers. That means with some few distance restrictions are there and few amount of data speed restrictions are there. But later they got one idea that why can't we interconnect cities also. Okay, that's how this MAN area network comes into the picture here. So now I can interconnect Hyderabad to Chennai, Chennai to Bangalore, or Bangalore to Mumbai, or Mumbai to Delhi also I can interconnect. So how all these networks can be interconnected means with the help of these metropolitan area networks. The size it is increased compared to the LAN, or else we can say it a combination of LANs is also a MAN also, in such a way also we can say. Okay, so that means it is trying to cover all the areas which are there in that particular city. It can be the towns, anything which is there in that particular city, we can interconnect from one city to the other cities. Okay, so that is the thing. So here, what example they gave it for the man is, a man is the best example in case of a telecommunications company networks. Telecommunications company networks with some high-speed DSL line to the customers. Okay. How the telecommunication networks usually will work? Okay. From a telephone central office, from a telephone central office to some particular area, they will be having some boxes will be there. That means just like set-top boxes, some box connections will be there. And from there, they will be providing their high-speed DSL lines, means digital subscriber lines. So that particular digital subscriber lines, they will be sending to each and every individual customers. Whenever we are having that landline phones, this is the thing which will be happening. But we don't have now, no more landlines are existing now. Only few people are using that landline phones. Okay, now we are going to use that telephone lines only for this internet purpose and all. Okay, suppose, and one more best example, we can take it as our cable TV networks. So how our cable TV networks will be there? Okay, at some particular street or to some particular area, they will be having some junction points will be there or some boxes will be arranged. So from that boxes, he will be connecting to each and every individual houses. So that's how your cable TV networks will be connected. So in the same way, your metropolitan area networks also will be connected. So these are some examples we can consider it for the metropolitan area networks. But in compared to the LAN, the size will be more and the amount of data that which we can transmit, it is also more. Okay, we can transmit from one cities to the other cities very easily. We can share our data, we can send our mails. Okay, anything we can do it here. And next, now you come to this one, that is wide area networks. So what is this wide area networks? What is this wide area networks? Sumant, are you there?
Oh, ma'am.
Yes, right. Next, wide area networks means, see here. So we have seen interconnecting to some individual houses, to some individual offices or organizations or any companies. Next, we started interconnecting to the cities. Next, if you come to the wide area networks, come for the interconnection throughout the world. Okay, that means long distance data transmissions of voice data, or it can be the audio files, or it can be the video files, anything which you want to share, you can share it very easily with the help of the internet. That itself is called as wide area networks. So here, this our internet, it plays a major role in connecting all the cities, continents, okay, countries, and as well as, okay, that is called as wide area networks. So now, if I want to speak with the person who is residing in the other countries, or that just like US or Canada, I can speak it very easily. I can share my data very easily. Is it true or not? I can do my voice calls. I can do my, previously it's not the case. It is very difficult to make a normal voice call also. They will be charging 12 rupees per minute. That is the case. But now we got n number of applications just to do the video calls, or we are now doing the video calls. We forgot about audio calls. Okay, so that's how our technology, it has been increased. Okay, so if you are trying to interconnect all the countries and continents, that means throughout the world we can share our data. So such type of network is called as wide area networks. Okay, and as well as one more thing is here two types of connections are there. That is, one is the point to point WANs and as well as the switched WANs. Okay, in the WANs again, two types of WANs will be there. One is the point to point WAN, this is the point to point WAN, and this is the switched WAN. See here, if you observe very clearly, in the point to point WAN, how your computer is connected here. So here, this is my computer, I can connect it to my modem. So modem, I told you that what is the role of modem means, it will convert your audio signals into the digital signals, analog signals into the digital signals, and digital signals again, it can be converted to the analog signals. So that is the role of the modem here. So whenever any data that which it is coming from the outside of your network, that means before the modem, it will be considered as the analog signal. But once after entering to the modem, it will be converting into the digital signals, and that particular digital signals we are trying to connect to your computers. Okay, so it is connected to the one more modem, and that particular modem again it is connected to the ISP providers. ISPs are nothing but internet service providers. Okay, directly my computer, it is connected to the internet service providers. Okay, who are the internet service providers here? So daily we are going to use the n number of internet service providers. We are having Apollo Internet is there, Hathway Connections are there, still many more are there, right? Those are nothing but some of the internet service providers. From there, if I am going to get access my internet directly to my individual homes, means that is called as point to point WANs. Okay, but see here, this is my end system. If you come to the switched WAN, this is my end system and this is my end system. So here in between, n number of switched WANs are there. These are nothing but the switched WAN. Okay, this particular entire network is called as a switched WAN. So if you want to interconnecting any other metropolitan cities or like that, means again we have to interconnect from one ISP internet service provider to the other internet service providers in the other cities and other, as well as other countries also. If it comes to other countries, means internet access points will be there. We need to connect to that access point, and from there to the individual geographical location, it will be interconnected. Okay, so this much thing will be happening in the switched WAN. So directly, if we are connecting to the, see, in my home, I will be connected to the Hathway internet. So that is called as point to point WAN. Directly, I can connect to the internet service provider. But sometimes there may be a chance that internet service providers, again, it will be different in one city or one country. Okay, they will not be the same, but we have to interconnect to that particular location of a customer who is going to reside in the other state or other countries. So we need to find out, we need to interconnect to that access points, and from there it will be connected to the end user systems. So that's how your switched WAN is going to work here. So that is the reason in between, n number of switched WANs will be there. Okay, to interconnect from one end system to the another end system. But the thing is, in case of wide area networks, the things with that which we need to keep in mind is, in the wide area networks, everything, whatever the data that which we are trying to send in online, right? So in online means with one click, I am going to get all my information. With one click, I am going to get, I can retrieve all the information which is stored in the data centers, right? So I am not, I don't have, that means there is no need of storing my data in my local computer and all. Okay, somewhere the data will be stored, and I am trying to retrieve that particular data to my local computer. So as it is, everything is online, definitely there may be some disadvantages are also there. So the only disadvantage is providing the security to the customers or the users who are going to access the data in online. So that is the major issue which we have to consider in the wide area networks. Okay, so that means wide area networks, it will interconnect all the cities, countries, and as well as continents also. The only thing is, with the help of the internet, it is possible. With the help of the internet, it is possible here. The only major constraint here is we have to consider about security issues. So nowadays, n number of hackers and cyber criminals are growing a lot. So we need to protect our data whenever we are trying to send any confidential information in online. So that's how we need to take care while sending the information using the wide area networks. Okay. So this is all about the categories of networks. So only thing is, distance constraints are there. So interconnection of networks. See here, interconnection of networks. So we have seen the LAN, MAN, and as well as WAN. That means separately we have seen here. But if you are trying to interconnect all these LAN, MAN, and WAN, means it will becomes an inter network. That means heterogeneous networks we are trying to interconnect here.
That type of network is called as internetwork.
Okay, that type of network is called as internetwork or internet. Okay, see here, I think they have given one diagram here. Yeah, this is the diagram. Okay, Neha, are you there?
Yes, ma'am, I'm there.
Okay, please take the screenshots, ma. Who is your class here?
Lipika,
I don't know. Who is that?
Nikita and Saiteja.
Nikita and Saiteja. Saiteja, are you there?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ah, okay, ma. At the end, better you take the screenshots.
Okay.
Okay. Don't forget, whenever the participants count is high, you take the screenshots. Okay, next. This is the way, how can we interconnect the different types of networks here? See here, this is the LAN. Is it true or not? This is the LAN here. But here we are having one point to point WAN is there. Okay. In the previous topic, we have discussed about the topologies, right? So if you come to the categories of networks, LAN, WAN and WAN is there. LAN, all the LAN networks can use the different topologies. Can use the different topologies means I can use my LAN to interconnect using the hub topology or using the mesh topology or using the I can use my star topology, mesh topology or ring topology. Anything I can use to interconnect my devices in a LAN network. Okay, see here, this is one of the, in this particular point to point LAN, they have used the star topology in interconnecting the LAN. But here it's not the case. Here they have used the linear topology or bus topology, they have used it. Okay, so here from these, this is a LAN and this is also the LAN here, and they are trying to interconnect. So where is your end system? So this is the president. Who is that president? He is residing somewhere in US or UK, but we need to talk to that person sitting from my LAN here. So how can I talk means in between this many network devices are there. Okay, you keep in mind network devices means it can be anything. It can be your routers or it can be your switches or it can be anything. Okay. See here. So with the help of the point to point LAN, I am trying to interconnect it with the switched WANs. And from these switched WANs to the modem, okay, to the modem, that means in that particular country, access points will be there. To that access point, to the individual modem, to where that particular president system is connected. Okay, president system is also having one modem will be there. Okay, that particular modem, it will be connected to the one more, that means to where he wants to interconnect, to that particular access point modem it will be connected, that means to the ISP's modem it will be connected, and from there to the switched WANs, and from these switched WANs to our individual computer. So that's how all your different types of networks are there. So here LAN is there, here WAN is there, and as we are trying to interconnect all this throughout the world, this is considered as a wide area networks. Okay, so we are trying to interconnect all the different types of heterogeneous networks using the digital line subscribers, that is the DSL lines. Okay, is it fine? And the next topic is the internet. So how the internet plays the major role nowadays, and as well as how this came into picture and all. Previously, when we were there at 2000 or like that, we know already how to use our email and all. Okay, at that time there is no concept of chatting and all. I think we know only Yahoo mails, and that is Yahoo mails is there. Google search engine is there, but not this much widely. Okay, as we are using now, only static document pages will be there where we can view that particular documents. But now time to time updations will be there, and many things we can download it. But at that time it's not the case like that. Only whatever the documents are there, we can see and we can view and we can close it, etc. And that's how It started, but now it's not the case. We know we know only Rediff Mail and as well as Yahoo Mail, but now we are going to use n number of mails here. See, let's see what is the brief history of that particular internet, how it started in the previous days, in the traditional days. Okay, so what is meant by a network? First of all, we know that interconnecting all the devices from one using the network is nothing but a network, right? That means in the traditional days, they are doing some research on this particular network. At that time, they are having some computers are there. See here, that means in the mid 1960s and all, they are having some research organizations. In that particular research organizations, they are having only standalone computers are there. So how these standalone computers are there means, in that particular standalone computers, in that particular standalone computers, so whatever the data is there, they can store it, and that particular data they are unable to share with the other people who are there in the other organizations. Okay, and here the thing is, later the computers from the different manufacturers, they were unable to communicate with one another. That is the biggest problem they are going to face in the research organizations. So later, this particular Advanced Research Projects Agency, okay, that is nothing but ARPA. So before giving the name as internet, they have given it as ARPANET only. They have given the name as ARPANET. Okay, so in the Department of Defense, that means generally they started only for the defense applications and all. Okay, they got interest and they started working on how to connect the computers. Okay, and how they interconnect the computers, and they want to share their data, they want to talk one computer with the other computers. So that's how their research started. And later in 1967, with the ACM, in the ACM meeting, what is that ACM full form means? Association for Computing Machinery. Association for Computing Machinery. In that particular meeting, they have presented their ideas for the ARPANET. Okay, they have presented their ideas. What is their idea? To interconnect the two computers. So that idea they have presented. So that's how they started. And but how they have been done means with the help of one specialized computer that is called as interface message processor. With the help of interface message processor, they could able to interconnect the two devices. That means they can share their data. Okay, later in 1969, this ARPANET, it became reality. Reality means they implemented that particular thing with the IMPs, interface message processors. Those who are leaving, please take care that the end, Saiteja, at the end you take the screenshot and that will be valid. Okay, those who are leaving in the middle, and we will not consider such type of things. Okay, and one more thing is, at the end, see here, so how they started interconnecting the devices means, in 1969 they started interconnecting only four nodes. Okay, what are those four nodes means? The first node they have tried to connect with the University of California, okay, which is at Los Angeles, and the second one is one more University of California at Santa Barbara. Okay, and one more thing is, one more university which is at Stanford, okay, research institute. And that means they have tried to interconnect the four universities first. And one more thing is the University of Utah. Okay, they have started and they succeeded actually. So they got one more idea that why can't we interconnect the other universities also which are there, so that we can interconnect and we can share our knowledge and as well as our data within these particular universities. Okay, so that's how they started. In the initial stages, they started communicating only with the four universities, and later it came into reality and it was worked. Okay, what is that software called? They use the software as a network control protocol. What is that one? Network control protocol they have used for communicating between these hosts. Okay, so that's how our ARPANET came into the picture. And later they have that means on paper they implemented what are the protocols they have used. So what is the protocol they have used for the transmission of data means, that is nothing but TCP, that is the transmission control protocol. So this they have used for the connection of devices and all. Okay, and one more thing is, and one more protocol also they exhibited here, that is the internetworking protocol, IP protocol also they have exhibited. So based upon these two protocols only, they could able to interconnect the four universities. And after some time, what happened means, why can't we interconnect with the other universities and which are there, and the other cities, other countries like that? They got one thought and it came into the picture. First name they have given it as ARPANET, and later they gave the name as internet. So that's how your, that is the history of your internet. This much picture is there for doing that research on how to interconnect the devices and all. Okay. And internet today, it's not a simple thing and all. We know already all the internet, how we are going to get our internet services, means basically with the help of the internet service providers. How many types of internet service providers are there? So see here, we are having the national service providers are there. That means for the country, providers will be there, and as well as regional service provider. Regional service provider means, suppose if Telangana is one region, so for that particular region again service providers will be there. Okay, and local service providers means which will be intended to some particular areas. Okay, that's how they have been represented hierarchically. Okay, see here, national service providers to the regional service providers, and regional service providers to the ISPs finally, and from these ISPs to the individual customers or individual organizations. That's how we are going to buy our that means this much amount of GBPS and all. So directly we can't get it. So this is the hierarchical organization of the internet and the structure of the national ISPs. And how your national ISPs can be interconnected means, this is the way how your national ISPs can be interconnected. That is with the help of network access points. Okay, these are the network access points. With the help of these network access points, we can interconnect to the national ISPs. That means within the different countries also, we can interconnect all the different types of national ISPs also. Okay, so this is about the internet history and how your national service providers will be working and all. Okay, so see here, I told you already that local internet service providers, these are nothing but where we are going to get the direct service to the end users. Okay, suppose if I am the individual person, I am going to get a direct services from the Hathway or some other internet service providers. Okay, directly I can be connected and I am going to get the internet. And for these people, again, they have to contact the regional internet service providers. So like that, hierarchically, they will be getting the categories of networks. So any doubts still here? Next, in the next class, we will see about this one, that is the protocols and standards. Okay, protocols and standards, and as well as one more important topic we will get here, that is the what are the different standards, organizations and all, and as well as we are having one layered technology is there. So that particular layered concepts also we will use it. Okay, layered tasks and as well as the layered model is there. So that is very, very important in the first unit. We will discuss that one also.